me a little bit about this particular Formula 5000 car.
It's a 1968 Lola T140. It was in the original batch that came to America for Haas. And we brought it into New Zealand about September, October last year. And this is its first debut meeting here. We've restored it back to 1969 spec. And seems to be a decent car.
So who was running it back in the day?
The original owner was a guy, Peter Helfrich. And then it went on in this livery to a guy, Dick Jacobs, who ran it for quite some time. And then it's raced its whole life. There's been numerous owners.
Okay, so it hasn't been parked up in a barn or anything like that anywhere. It's just been continually sort of raced.
From what we believe, the longest it was parked up was from when, between us purchasing it, was when a guy, we bought it from a deceased estate. I think it was 6 years was the only time it didn't race in its whole life.
So as a T140, it must be one of the older cars in the grid, is that right?
It is one of the older cars in the grid, but it's not one of the slowest. So.
Right, and Alan, give me a bit about your background. I believe you've got quite a bit of motorsport background, so this is just a step up for you, is it?
It's been a bit of a step I didn't expect. The last thing I drove in anger was Suzuki Swift Cup, which is a lot different to this. I started kart racing when I was 6 years old and just progressed from there, driving other things, Formula Vs. But now this is a huge step and really enjoying it.
So obviously there's quite a few 5000s on the grid. Have you actually had the chance to drive any other ones and compare them with us?
No, this is the first Formula 5000 I've driven and hopefully won't be the last, but yeah, first time I drove on was last Saturday, so I've probably turned about 50 laps in one so far.
So dry conditions yesterday, we haven't raced in the wet today yet. I guess you're feeling a little bit apprehensive about that, are you?
I think if it rains, I don't think we'll take it out. We haven't got any wet tyres with us this weekend, and it's not worth risking a car like this of its age and its value.
So you think you'll keep this for a while, just get used to the 5000 series? I mean, looking at anything else?
We're looking at moving up into a newer car, but we'll probably do this one. We'll probably run this car through the winter series and maybe even next year, just see how we go with finding another car.
Back in the day, this car, did it have any outstanding results, or was it just one of the pack?
It didn't have any outstanding results up until about mid-80s, where it won quite a few titles, Midwest in America for the all-in-brawl sort of single-seater races and stuff like that. So yeah, not really original history, but through its past it's had a few good drivers.